Melissa, I know you're really into autonomous driving, at least as a topic. I don't know if yes. you're into it as something that you want to own yourself. But so what happened here? What just happened in Pittsburgh?
What happened in Pittsburgh is that an art gallery owner got into an accident while his Tesla car was on the autopilot mode. And it's important to note that autopilot is actually in beta. Tesla introduced this last October. Look, you can drive autonomously, but we're just testing this and you can too. And so no big surprise, all these Tesla drivers who are all into Tesla technology and they're early adopters and they like to show things off, they all start using it, including doing things they're not supposed to do, like take their hands off the wheel. And there are, you can see it all over YouTube. Look, Ma, no hands.
And so the car, according to the driver, the car hit a guardrail, then went across the highway and rolled over and landed on its lid. But there's... We're taking this guy at his word, and Tesla is saying that they haven't confirmed this yet. So, yes. I mean, do you think that he could possibly be, and I'll ask Gordon too, do you think this guy might be trying to, like, take the onus off his own driver error and put it onto Tesla? Is it, because until it's confirmed that it actually was on autopilot, you know, it's his word against Tesla's.
Well, the cool thing about autopilot and about the Tesla cars in general is that they record everything they do. So I hope this guy isn't lying because we're going to figure that out pretty quickly.
Right. So Tesla said it has no data that says autopilot was engaged and they can't investigate further until the customer responds to Tesla's requests. At least that's what I read from the, I think it was Jalopnik. But yeah, so I think that's an interesting ripple. I mean, what do you think, Gordon? I mean, the paranoid person in me thinks, or rather the suspicious person in me thinks maybe this guy's trying to ride the wave of scrutiny against Tesla.
Yeah, I mean, it happened with the Toyota, you know, the unintended acceleration.
The self-exploding cars.
Yeah.
The guy in the Prius, you know, tried to fake his, you know, Prius running away. It turned out it wasn't really. That is a possibility, but I don't know. Apparently, I wouldn't be surprised if he was running autopilot mode. I mean, but for people who don't know, I was reading a story and they were saying that this part of the road is really dangerous.
Yeah.
It's
right.
like turning on autopilot and then driving up Highway 1,
where
when it makes a mistake, you are going to go 600 feet into the Pacific Ocean.
Yeah.
So it's not too smart to do that, but
it sounds like a ridiculous place to turn on autopilot.
But it does sound crazy. But I kind of wonder, maybe the problem is like, you know, look, it's like, hey, I'm running beta Windows 10. People run beta browsers. People run all kinds of beta hardware, software all the time. It can't hurt you. Otherwise, they wouldn't let you run it, right? Maybe that's a little different when it's actually your car driving down the road, right?
And so, I mean, going all the way back to the incident that happened in May, this guy who was a total Tesla enthusiast and had created YouTube videos about how he loved to drive with autopilot on, I think he was busted with 5 or 6 speeding tickets. I don't know if those were in the Tesla, but it seems pretty clear that he was watching a Harry Potter movie while he was going down the road. A huge truck turned into or crossed the highway, and that it might have hit a blind spot in Tesla's autopilot system. And it was a bright sky, white truck, and Tesla is basically saying, "Yeah, like our software isn't foolproof, but we warned you because this is in beta." So, I mean, do you think Tesla is culpable in this, or are they going to get off on because they warned everyone it's just beta?
This is really tough. I'm sure the lawyers are working hard on this. Even when they introduced it last year, people were wondering, is Tesla going to get away with just telling people, well, be careful because it's only beta? I think what's happening, unfortunately, especially with the May incident, is that they're finding that, you know, the fun of testing beta software in a car can be deadly.
Yeah. Yeah. So check out, there's a headline in The Guardian. So everyone's looking into, is Tesla going to get into big trouble?
Yeah.
This is from The Guardian. Tesla fatal autopilot crash. Family may have grounds to sue, legal experts say. Then here we have the LA Times. Tesla's autopilot mode puts it at risk for liability and crashes. And both these stories have law experts are saying by Tesla doing something that the other automakers haven't done, which is to release this full autopilot mode into the wild, they're actually making themselves much more, they're increasing their exposure to successful legal action.
Sure. I think they are, yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised if they decide basically very soon, hey, you want to do this beta program, you need to be like a qualified driver. We're not going to because clearly, and again, people think I can run beta all kinds of stuff and it's not deadly because it's beta, right? But it's your car and it may drive you into a brick wall. That's not a good idea. Yeah. People just assume that beta means, hey, that.
I think they at least make people sign something saying, yes, I could die.
Even then, it doesn't matter,
right?
Though.
Then it's okay.
You're still open to, I mean, the liability for them is going to be huge.
Is there terms of service for Tesla? I mean, like, what have you agreed to when you buy the car?
I was surprised when Tesla came out with this because a lot of other car manufacturers are working on autonomous driving, but they're like closed courses, trained drivers, not letting anyone normal near it.
Yeah, and Volvo is saying they'll accept all liability when they ever come out.
It ever comes out. But they're all, they keep pushing it out 5 years. Like it was 2020 and now it's 2021.
So do you think this could be part of Tesla's undoing? Because already they're having trouble, you know, finding the right profit model.
This could be very bad for Tesla. They have a lot of devoted users, and God knows a lot of devoted Apple users have let Apple get away with all sorts of crap. So, you know, it could work for Tesla, but unfortunately, you know, when Apple gets away with something, you usually don't die.
So what do you think about Elon Musk's, I think it's his statement, it's certainly Tesla's statement, that this crash happened, but think of all the millions and millions of driver miles or car-driven miles in autopilot where there wasn't a crash. And in fact, according to Tesla, driving autonomously is safer than having a human pilot the car.
Oh, well, I'm sure mathematically he's correct. I think it's just in the court of public opinion. You know, the scrutiny on autonomous driving is incredibly, incredibly harsh.
Yeah. So what do you guys think about that sort of, because it's my opinion that there's this in-between space where between completely human-driven driving and fully autonomous driving, there's that huge chasm, and in between is where it's most dangerous. This guy was lulled into thinking he was safe. So what's the solution? Do you wait until it could be fully autonomous? And is the only acceptable like model for that for everyone to be fully autonomous? Should we have a mixture of autonomous and humans?
Well, I'm a big believer in humans doing their job.
Yeah.
At the same time, there are, you know, to be fair to Tesla, there's a lot of people that should not be behind the wheel of a car, you know, especially a big gigantic, 6,000 pound SUV or something. But, you know, for those people, autopilot may indeed be safer, but maybe those people should be really on the bus, really, is what it is.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure if you take the same person to get to what he's saying, how safe self-driving is, but if you take that same person who's not safe in their own vehicle with them driving, are they really going to be safer with autonomous driving? I don't know.
They probably don't pay attention to what they're doing in either scenario. Yeah.
They may be more dangerous, honestly. You put these people into a situation where clearly this is not going to be here by 2020. I don't know who's fooling themselves,
but
this is not going to be 2020 technology. But you put that person into a car where it's like, yeah, it's safe 95% of the time. That person's going to find that margin and drive through, you know, like a building full of, you know, people. So.
Right. Yeah, I think there's something to be said for that, like that last 5% where you actually have to pay attention. If you are basically reading the paper, then you look up and you see the semi coming across your lane. Your reaction times, it's going to take
a little late.
It's going to take a few microseconds to sort of reboot into awareness mode, and those are microseconds you need to avoid that accident.
Yeah, I just don't. I really don't believe it can happen. I mean, if you look at airplanes can fly themselves practically.
Mm-hmm.
These things cost $100 million, you know, and when something goes wrong, everybody's like, how come these pilots can't fly these planes when something goes wrong?
Yeah.
Well, this idiot in this car, it's the same thing, right? They can't drive their car. Why in the world are they in a car anyway, even if it's driving itself 90% of the time?
Yeah.
God help you if you get an American out of their car.
Yeah. I agree. Staying in my car, and I'm driving it. Okay, any last words on this this Tesla thing, Melissa?
Good luck with that, Tesla.
All right.
Yeah, I think this will be the end of their. It's just it's clear that they had way too much trust in their customers. They really need to make it a closed beta for people who are like, look, man, this thing is not done yet. So
I agree with you. I also I find it. I think it's pretty remarkable that let's assume this latest incident is an actual autopilot accident. I think it's remarkable that there's only been two. But you know, again, it's about the court of public opinion, and that means a lot. You know,
yeah,
appearances
but, I mean,
matter.
Two out of how many cars, for God's sake? And yeah. They've only driven like 0 miles, basically. Like a long haul trucker probably drives as many miles as. As the entire West Coast Tesla.
I think I don't have the number in front of me, but I think autopilot. I think Tesla has data on how many autopilot driven miles.
Yeah, sure. It's a lot.
Have transpired, and it's a lot.
Yeah, it is a lot for an electric autonomous car. But I mean, frankly, if you took like 10 long haul truckers, they probably draw all of those miles in like. 2 years or a year.
130 million miles with autopilot activity.
And how many miles are driven by people just in America? That's probably worldwide.
Well, it's 130 million, but I bet I'd have to assume a lot of those are people are paying very close attention.
Yeah.
And I want to know how many were driven with people watching Harry Potter or reading the newspaper.
Yeah.
Well, you don't know. To me, the other creepy thing is just one last thing about but the totally creepy thing is like, every time there's one of these accidents, Tesla jumps out with like, look, you know, you were lying in your story about not being able to charge your car, or this person was lying about this. Man, I don't know why people get like freaked out about the government getting into your phone, but this corporation is using data from the device they've sold you to defend themselves from you suing them.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, that is like, where exactly is the line here?
The amount of data in the ECUs and how those could be extracted by the car companies, insurance companies, the government, it's crazy.
Yeah, and it's already happened. Not even
in
you know, really advanced cars. Are using them in
GM does it.
Cars.
Ford does it.
I would almost want like, man, I almost want like a 65 Mustang, you know, on the car. It's like, you know, I don't want you to have all that information.
Yeah.